Are you a baseball fan in a relationship with someone who's not a baseball fan? Don't worry, I'm in the same situation, and here are my tips to help you out. Hey guys, it's Josh and Nanny Know It All. Come to you today with kind of a fun video. It actually was an idea my wife gave me. As I mentioned in the intro, I'm a huge baseball fan, obviously. She is not. She is not a big fan of baseball. She's more of a football fan. That's what her family kind of grew up on. She understands that game a little better. But she gave me some ideas of things to talk about to help out individuals like me who have, significant others who aren't baseball fans, things that we can do to make the game a little more enjoyable for them. Before we jump into that, guys, take a moment, hit subscribe just down below, click on that. It lets you know when new videos are coming out. That way you can keep up to date with us. It actually helps the channel out too. If you don't want to find that, or maybe you're watching this on the website, if you go up here right at the end of the video, there'll be a 90 Know It All logo. Click on that, and you can subscribe that way as well. So, guys, let's jump into this really quickly. This is going to be really a fun one. The first couple ones are serious. I've got seven tips for you. The first few are going to be kind of serious. The last few are going to be serious, but with a little fun to it. So let's go into it. First one, right off the bat, teaching how to keep score and teaching the basic terminology of baseball. One of the things my wife talks about is that she doesn't understand the game. Now, I grew up playing baseball. My family's done baseball and softball, since day one. I mean, some of my earliest memories are going to softball tournaments with my dad, going to the Kingdome to watch the Mariners play as a 2, 3, 4 year old. So baseball has really been my family thing. Well, that and Disneyland. So that's what I've been growing up doing all my life. I'm used to it. I know things. There are things I know about the game that I don't even think about. I just automatically know. And for a lot of you who are baseball fans and played, you have the same thing. You know what's going on without even being told or without even noticing that you're aware of that. So it's important to let individuals know about the game. Keeping score is a great thing because you can actually help them stay involved in the game. In between pitches, they're filling stuff out. It's not that dead space, that dead air time. They can kind of get boring for an individual. So help them learn how to keep score, teach them the basic terminology, help them understand even things like balls, strikes, outs, innings, top of the inning, bottom of the inning, pickoff. I mean, there's so much stuff that we just take for granted on how basic it is for us because we grew up liking this sport for years that others who are new to it don't understand. One of the best examples for me, I'm not a rugby fan. But I can sit and watch it, but I have no clue what's going on. No one's ever sat down and told me what the rules are officially, what the different things are representing or what they're doing. I just enjoy the action. So I think if someone actually explained rugby to me, I'd probably enjoy that even more. So knowing the game, understanding the terminology, that's a good first step to getting someone excited about the game of baseball. Second thing, now this one I actually thought of myself. My wife confirmed that she agrees with it. You need to have good seats. If you're taking someone who's not a big baseball fan and you're sitting in the 300 level or you're sitting out in deep left center field where they can barely see the game, they're not going to have fun because they don't see what's going on. That far out, it's hard to see all the different action that's happening in the infield, the catchers. You just can't see it all. Yes, you might get the big panoramic view of the game, but if you aren't a big fan of the game, you don't care about that. You want to be closer to the action. That's why my recommendation is if you have someone who is not a baseball fan and you want to take them to a game, don't go to a Major League Baseball game. Go to a minor league game or a college game because for those stadiums, you're going to get close. I mean, I don't think there's been a stadium that I've gone to in minor league baseball where any seat is really bad. You're always in good seats, you're closer to the game, it's cheaper, so you can buy the even closer seats to the dugout. So that way they can see the game, be active in what's going on. Kind of be a participant really as a fan. That's why I love college baseball. I cover Lower Columbia here in Longview, Washington, all throughout the spring, and right behind home plate, they have this area that's designed for, having food and relaxing, but the tickets are the same price. So if you pay $5 to get in, you sit anywhere in the ballpark you want. So I know what I do when I'm done photography taking photos. I take a chair, sit down behind the net, and I'm watching the game from right there against the net, right behind home plate, and it's awesome. And even then, let's say that area is filled up, I go sit in the bleachers right behind, which is 8 feet behind me, 10 feet behind me, and up a little bit higher, so even better view for some things. So get good seats. If you get good seats, it's easier to enjoy the game. It's easier to see what's going on, to be active as a fan. So those are the first two things. Number three, a lot of people who aren't baseball fans don't have a team to root for. Maybe they'll choose a team by what their uniforms look like or something else like that. But when you're rooting for a team simply because their uniform is blue or their uniform is red or their mascot is a dinosaur or something like that, it's not real exciting. You kind of get bored. There isn't a connection with that team. So one of the things you can do is help them find a player or a team to connect with and become fans of. A lot of times having stories, backstories of individuals, kids who, maybe played in a different area, have traveled a long ways to be a part of the team, or different things like that. Just getting to know the players and the team helps someone connect and helps them become a fan of the team, and that makes the game more enjoyable. Now, granted, once again, for those of us who are diehard baseball fans, we could go to a random little league anywhere, sit in the bleachers, have a hamburger, hot dog, and just have fun watching a game. We don't care who's playing. But for those people who aren't fans, we gotta give them a little more reason to get excited, a little more reason to become a fan and to enjoy the game. So, let's say you are teaching them how to keep score, you get good seats, you're trying to tell them about the team that you love and why you love them. That's not really working. So, number four, my recommendation here is buy them food. Go buy food. Like I just mentioned, for Little League, you go to a Little League, you buy a hamburger, which, let's be honest, Little League hamburgers may be some of the best hamburgers in the country. Just, I love getting a hamburger and fries at Little League. But you're sitting there, good food, you're relaxing. It's a lot more enjoyable to enjoy, to be an event or a game if you have a good meal in front of you. It doesn't have to be fancy. I mean, if you're outside just relaxing in the sun, having a hamburger or a hot dog, something like that, it's good. It's fun. It helps you, one, you're full, and when you're full, you feel better. So that helps out. So go to a game, get some nachos, get a hamburger, get a hot dog, get them something to eat. So that way, when they're in the stands, they're not just there to watch a game, they're actually there eating, and the game is just there as well. That does help make it more enjoyable. Let's say you do that, it's not working. My fifth idea is show them the fun things that happen around the stadium. Now, this is where going to a major league game is sometimes better. Up on the Jumbotrons, they usually have like the three hats that mix the ball around you. I guess which one the ball's in, or they have like music trivia. At least this is what the Mariners do. Last time I was up there, Mariners also have their hydro boat races. They have like the red, the yellow, and the green, and they have them. They're computer animated, and they race them around. And then they do like a shark will knock one off, and one will do a flip. And you gotta pick which color you think is gonna win. My wife loves doing that. My daughter, when we took her up there, she loved doing that stuff. So those are fun little things that they can do on the side, especially if you have kids. Minor league ballparks are great about having, like different areas where they can go play, different play areas. The Salem Kaiser Volcanoes, a team that you guys know I've sometimes been harsh on and negative on in the past, has actually done a tremendous job. They have all those bouncy castles and slides and climbing areas back in the back area behind the bleachers on the third base side. And it's amazing. It's amazing. I'll take my daughters down there and let them just play for a little while. And they have tons of fun down that area because it's fun, it's relaxing, they enjoy it. It's something for them to do. So even though they're not diehard baseball fans, they can still go have fun at the game. So when I tell them, hey, we're going to a game and you guys can go play there, they get excited about that. But so there's lots of stuff that happens around the stadium, around the concourse. Minor league and college wood bat teams have those in-between inning games and things that go on. Those are hilarious. Those are fun to watch. I love the ones where the individuals are like tied together and they gotta pull each other in a tug of war. It's fun. Things like that are enjoyable. Even if you're not a baseball fan, you still laugh at that, you still have fun with that. Makes the game experience a positive one. Okay, number six. This one, my wife insists, is very serious. extremely serious. So it may sound like a joke, not a joke. Take it serious. She says one of the things that helps her enjoy a game is if I buy her a cute shirt, like a cute Mariner shirt or whatever minor league team we go to. If I buy her a cute shirt, so that way she is a fan of the team because she has their shirt on, but she looks cute wearing it and being supportive of the team. So, guys, I'm telling you right now, if you have a girlfriend, fiance, if you have a wife, daughters, that they're not really big into baseball, but you want to get them to go there, buy them a cute shirt. Let them go and show off that they're a fan with their cute shirt. It sounds weird, it does, but I'll be honest, I've done it in the past. We've gotten cute shirts. We've gone to different stores or order things online ahead of time. And, especially like when my oldest daughter, when she was first born, our first games that we took her to were the Mariners versus the Dodgers back in 2012. And we bought her some really cute Mariner onesies. And so my wife was all excited to have her go to the games wearing her brand new Mariner onesies. And we took pictures of her at each game in her onesie. So buy cute shirts, cute hats, whatever it takes to get them excited about going to the game and showing off their wardrobe, their outfit. It works. It does work. Take it serious. Go for it. Number seven, last thing I've got for you. And this one should be a no-brainer, especially in a relationship, but it's not. Especially for us baseball fans, we don't always get it, but here it is. If they're willing to go to a baseball game with you, be willing to go to do something with them that they like and maybe you're not a fan of. I don't know if that's pottery class, cooking class, dance class, I don't know what. But if there's something that they're into and they're willing to go to a baseball game with you, make a compromise. Go to their stuff as well. Sometimes that will help out one in a relationship, being able to compromise and do things that they like. But it also might show them that you're serious, that you want them to really to enjoy the game of baseball, and you're willing to go do stuff with them to show them how important baseball is to you. If you're willing to make that trade and say, "Hey, baseball means this much to me. It's so important that I'm willing to go do this, something I don't like, because it's important to you," that actually might help a lot. It might. And in fact, most cases, I would say it makes it easier when you say, "Hey, I want to go to a game," or "Let's go to a game." They may be more open to doing that or letting you go by yourself. I mean, let's be honest, going to a game by yourself isn't the worst thing either, but it's always fun to go to a game and have people there with you that you can talk with, you can hang out with, share a hot dog, a nacho, a hamburger, fries, whatever it is you do, ice cream in one of those helmet cups. That's something you gotta get for someone, especially if you have kids. Find out if a stadium has ice cream in the helmet cups and teach them to collect the helmet cups. That might draw them as a fan. But guys, all of that, the biggest thing is just make the experience enjoyable. If you can make the experience enjoyable, whether it be for a spouse, whether it be for a kid or niece or a nephew, it draws them in and helps them build their love for the game, which may never be as strong as your love, but they may at least enjoy it, and that builds the fan base for baseball and makes the future of baseball stronger. That's the goal. Make baseball stronger in the long run. So, guys, those are my thoughts, my tips. Once again, a lot of those tips came from my wife, who is not a baseball fan, but she tolerates it mainly because she knows, well, this is what I do for 8 months of the year, and the other 4 months, I'm wishing I was doing it the other 8 months. So, she knows, she understands, and she's been great about it. And you know what? It's all because I've been willing to do other things with her. Not as much as I probably should, but I do buy her cute shirts. So, guys, I'm Josh, the 90 Know-It-All, and I will talk to you later.